This week on The Wire, owners exploit seller's market, first home buyer market share up 50%, and big banks tip lengthy boom. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in real estate, finance, investment and more. Our top story for this week, owners exploit seller's market. So with buyers outnumbering sellers and prices rising, an increasing number of homeowners are planning to put properties on the market. Now, research commissioned by Westpac surveyed just over 2,000 Australian homeowners and found that 35% of them want to sell in the next 5 years. And that's with 12% already in the process of listing or planning to do so this year. Now, Westpac senior economist Matt Hassan says it's absolutely a seller's market at the moment. Sales have seen a big lift over the last 4 months and are up over 36% on a year ago, resulting in significant tightening in supply with listings across the major capital cities now at a 12-year low. Now, most homeowners, that's 87%, plan upgrades before selling, spending an average of $32,000 on projects such as minor repairs, 44%, fresh paint, 44% also, or kitchen upgrades, 19%. Now, Anthony Hughes, Managing Director of Mortgages at Westpac, says property aspirations have shifted in the last 12 months. One in five homeowners are selling for reasons related to the pandemic, such as working from home more and seeking more space. Now guys, for our next story, first home buyer market share up 50%. So much of the demand that has allowed property markets to defy the 2020 doomsday predictions has been driven by first home buyers. Now the Real Estate Institute of Australia says first home buyers increased their market share 50.4% over 2020, motivated by the higher level of government incentives on offer. Now REIA President Adrian Kelly says seeing this trend in conversion to home ownership is particularly great news given the challenges many tenants and investors faced over the pandemic. He says, however, that surging house prices could impact housing affordability unless measures to improve supply are implemented. Now, Kelly says the proportion of income required to meet loan repayments has increased to 34.8%, which is up 0.9 percentage points. Now, New South Wales is the least affordable state with 44.6% of income required to meet loan repayments, whereas the Northern Territory is the most affordable state with a proportion of income required to meet loan repayments only 21.9%. Now, guys, for our final story of the week, big banks tip lengthy boom. So ANZ CEO Shayne Elliott says the housing boom could go on for quite a while given the high demand and ease of securing credit. House prices grew nationally by an average of 2.1% in February, and economists, including Commonwealth Bank's Gareth Aird, are predicting that house prices nationally will rise 16% the next 2 years. Now CBA predicts prices will lift 9% in 2021 and 7% in 2022. And given that several markets nationally, including Canberra, Hobart, Darwin, regional New South Wales, regional Tasmania, and regional South Australia, are currently growing at annual rates well above 10%, these forecasts may be conservative. Now, Elliott says the question of whether the boom is healthy depends on where you sit in the market. If you're an owner, it probably feels pretty healthy, he says. If you're trying to get into the market, it probably doesn't. I think extreme moves either up or down are never very good if they're sustained for a period of time. So it's starting to get into the area where people are starting to raise a few eyebrows, wondering if it's a bit unhealthy at these levels. And that's all from Shayne Elliott, CEO of ANZ. Well, guys, they're the top stories happening this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week. And remember, guys, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.